क्लास नाइन सॉरी क्लास टेन वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द चैप्टर मैडम राइड्स द बस. वी हैव कंप्लीटली रेड द चैप्टर. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स दैट आर गिवन इन द एनसीईआरटी बुक आल्सो. एंड नाउ फर्दर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द डिस्कशन ऑफ सम एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट ऑन बोर्ड इज दैट हु वाज वाली एंड व्हाई डिड शी कीप स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ द house or in front of the door of her house. So who was Wali? You people will give me answers. Why does she keep standing in front of the door of a house? So why did she keep standing there? Yes. So why did she stand there? Yes, Bhumika. And don't, Bhumika, mute yourself again and again, okay? I have unmuted you once. Yes, why she was standing?
Ma'am, Wali was an 8-year-old girl. Hmm. And she was fond of seeing the bus that used to go around from her house street.
Hmm.
She likes to see the bus as she wants to sit in the bus for once.
Yes, she had a strong desire to have a ride in the bus. So she used to keep watching the other happenings in the street. And moreover, she also wanted to, she was curious to know about the bus service that was continuing, or that was, you can say, forwarding between her village and that of town. Okay, so the next question is, what was the most fascinating thing that Wali saw in the street? What was the most fascinating thing that Wali see in the street? So what was the most fascinating thing that Wali see in the street? What was that most fascinating thing? Yes. Who will speak? Raghav Arora, Anshika. Yes. Kanishka, I have unmuted you. You can give the answers now. Ruhani. Where is Ruhani gone? Yes, Ruhani. Yes. Speak the answer. Any one of you can speak. What was the most fascinating thing?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, please.
The most fascinating thing that Wali saw on the street was the bus that traveled between her village and near town.
Hmm.
It passed to nearest town and it passed through her street each hour.
So what was the most fascinating thing? The most fascinating thing that Wali saw on the street was the bus that traveled between her village and the town. She was most excited, or she was too excited to see that bus service, as she had never traveled a bus, and she was fascinated towards the journey, or to have a journey in that bus, right? So the next question is, how did she gather all the information about the bus? So how did she gather all the information about the bus? She gathered all the information about the bus by asking discreet questions to the neighbors and the other passengers who has boarded the bus. She has asked, or she has gathered information about, or she had asked discreet questions about the, you can say, about the timings of the bus, when it is coming back and when it is going from the village to the town, how much time it takes towards its one-sided journey, and what was the fare of the town. So she collected all the required information for her bus journey, right? Next is, what did Wali keep on planning and calculating continuously? What did Wali keep planning and continuously counting? So what was she planning and continuously counting? So what was she planning and continuously counting? So what she was planning and continuously counting? She was planning her bus journey continuously. She was counting the money she needed for one-sided bus fare as by asking some discreet questions to the neighbors. She has come to know that the one-sided fare for the bus was 30 paise. So she has sacrificed, she has stifled her strong desire to ride a bus, stifled her desire to have a ride in the merry-go-round in the village fair. And moreover, she has also sacrificed her desires to eat peppermints and to have other sweets. And she was continuously counting and planning for her bus journey. She was also counting that how much time she would require in order to undertake her one-sided journey, so that on the basis of that, she would go for a bus ride to the town. Is it clear? Right? So the next question is, how did Wali save money? How did Wali save money to travel in the bus? How did Wali save money to travel in the bus? How she has saved money to travel in the bus? So how she has saved money to travel in the bus? Yes. So this I have explained in the previous answer also. First of all, she had asked some discreet questions about the complete information for the bus, that when the bus leaves and comes back, how much time it takes to have a complete round from village to the town and from town back to the village. Moreover, she has saved every penny that comes her way, although it was a very small amount, that is 60 paise for her, once for her, you can say, return from the village, but that really costs a fortune for her. So she has also stifled her desire to, you can say, she has also stifled her desire to get those peppermints and those other sweets. And moreover, she has also stopped herself not to have a ride in the merry-go-round in the village fair. Okay, so this is the main thing, how she has gathered money. So explain the view outside the bus when it traveled along, when it traveled along the canal. So explain the view of the village when it traveled along the canal. So how was it? Can anybody explain? So how was it? No answers? How was it? So let me explain. So when the bus traveled along the canal, there were, you can say, vast area which was covered with greenery. Moreover, there were palm trees grown on the side of the canal. On one side of the canal, there was road, and on the other side, there were ditches. Okay, there were mountains, there were small, you can say, settlements called hamlets, and the entire area, from the vast area, it was covered with greenery. Okay, there were distant mountains also, and moreover, there was blue sky, and she even saw a cow, okay, while going towards the town, that ran galloping in front of the bus, that came running in front of the bus. Okay, so next question is, How did Wali feel on seeing the cow dead on the road? How did Wali feel on seeing the cow dead on the road? How she felt? She felt quite disturbed. There is no doubt that she felt quite disturbed when she saw the cow dead on the road. Okay, she was deeply hurt as the lovable creature which one sees in life, which was one, you can say, moving enthusiastically with life on the road, but now it has turned out to be a very horrible creature with his legs wide apart. Okay, with legs spread and moreover the eyes, you can say, fixed at a particular gaze, giving it a very horrified look. Okay, clear this answer, students? Yes, clear. 10th class, you are the most, you can say, silent ones. You people never speak anything.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you please repeat?
Which one? This one. So first of all, when she looked at the cow, when it was in life, it was quite lovable as well as amusing creature. That made Wali, you can say, clap her hands with in excitement and with glee. But later on, when Wali has seen the same creature lying on the ground as dead, she felt it quite horrible. Why she felt it horrible? It was because of the reason that the cow was stiff, okay, or the cow's body was stiff with legs completely spread up. And moreover, the eyes were, you can say, the eyes fixed on a particular angle with wide open, or eyes were wide open at a particular angle, giving it a horrified look. So this is the reason how she felt really bad for the cow. So now I'll write down one more question. The people and surroundings are a great book to learn. How Wali has learned, okay? And Wali in this lesson, she learns a lot from others. Okay, how? And Wali learns from other characters. How? So how she has learned a lot from other characters? Yes. Who will explain? Can anybody speak about this? That how she has learned a lot from other characters? Yes, Anshika, can you give a try? Akhilesh, Raghav Arora, Kanishka. Anybody can? If you won't practice here, I don't think so you will be able to produce your answers in exams. You will be short of words, that I'm sure. Yes, Anshika.
The people and surroundings are a great book to learn. Wali had learned a lot from others. In this, we can say that Wali used to stand at the front of her door, and she used to see the things that various things going on the street. Even she got to know about the fear of the bus by the people or by her friends who had traveled in that bus.
Then,
after traveling in the bus, she had, after conversating to the conductor, she had seen that how the conductor is a joyful person, joyful person or giving him respect in a sarcastic way. Even she had met an old woman who was asking her to sit straight or whether she won't fall from the seat.
So now let me explain it at once, that there is no doubt that people and surroundings are a great lesson to learn. It is not only for Wali but for all of us. Okay, Wali, since her journey right from her village, she has learned a lot. Okay, first of all, she learned how to gather information. She has asked discreet questions from the neighbors, from the passengers who have boarded the bus as the bus traveled between her village. Then she has also learned a lesson to save money, as she has stifled her desires to purchase peppermints and other sweets which she was tempted towards, or which what she was tempted to in the village fair. Okay, apart from it, during her bus journey, she had a beautiful view of the outer landscape, and she has also developed a sense of admiring nature. Okay, moreover, when the conductor was telling her, she also behaved in a very commanding as well as in an authoritative manner with that of the bus conductor. That shows her, you can say, confidence. This also, her fulfillment of her desire, this has completely, you can say, the fulfillment of her desire that has instilled in her confidence. She has turned out to be complete confident girl like that of a young woman. And moreover, when she has seen that repulsive lady chewing betel nut, sitting along with her, she has developed an aversion towards her. She was quite repulsive towards the presence of that woman, but she knew that she should be quite, you can say, she should be mindful while talking to these kind of old people. And moreover, while returning back from the bus, okay, while going towards the town, she has seen the cow galloping in front of the bus. And moreover, when she has returned back, she has seen the same, you can say, cow lying there with the legs spread eagled, spread wide apart, and moreover the eyes, you can say, fixed at a particular angle, showing a horrible look. Okay, so she has experienced life as well as death on a bus journey. So she has great experiences, and it is just because of this reason that has made her speak in the end that with so many things going amidst us, and we don't come to know about all these things. Okay. So this means every experience that she has gone through this bus journey, it has provided her a new experience of life, and ultimately she has also experienced death. Okay. And how everything comes silent and how everything behaves after death, she has also come to know. Okay. So this is all about the discussion of this, you can say, chapter, Madam Rides the Bus. And now we are having just 10 minutes with us. And for that, we are going to revise letter to editor. Okay. So the format I'm going to discuss here. So as we have already discussed the format a number of times. Okay. So the short one I'm going to discuss here. So for letter to editor, you know what is letter to editor. Letter to editor is written to the head of, you can say, to the editor of a newspaper. Why? In order to present your views. When you want to air your views, when you want to present your views to the people on some grim issue, on some, you can say, hot topic or some debatable topic, or sometimes it is not. You want to, you can say, spread awareness also about any, you can say, prevalent situation of the society. You want that people should come to know that, no, this is the right way, or this is happening, and it will also help to formulate their opinion, no doubt in it. Okay, so this we are going to write in letter to editor. Okay, so first of all, for letter to editor, you will first of all have sender's address in three lines. You will leave line, date, then you will have receiver's address. In receiver's address, you will write down the editor. Okay, name of newspaper and from where it is published. Suppose it is published from New Delhi or it is being published from Chandigarh. So you will write down it there. Okay, so next, afterwards, subject. what it is all about, to spread awareness or problem of this, whatever it is, you will mention it here. Your subject should be concise, precise, but catchy and completely related to the content of the letter. Then, dear sir or sir, you can write down for an official letter. Then para one, which is our introductory para. So how you will start? You will start with for example, as you are or through the column of your esteemed newspaper, I would like to bring to your notice the problem of this, which is prevailing, and the concerned authorities who have turned a deaf ear. Deaf ear means that they are not at all listening to what you are saying. Okay, so you can start in this manner. Okay, suppose you can write down, through the esteemed columns of your widely circulated newspaper, I would like to present my views. Means in the one paragraph, in first paragraph, you will write about the problem, what actually the problem is, and how it is completely incomplete, how it is affecting the people, how it is affecting people. So you will write it in this manner. Okay, fine. So now afterwards, you will be going to para 2. Next, in para 2, what you will write on para 2, you will write problem in detail. Write problem in detail. In detail means you will present all the facets. Okay, all the, you can say facets of the, you can say the problem, how it is affecting people, how people are being affected, what kind of effect does it have upon the life of people. Okay, so how people are suffering because of it, what is the, you can say, general attitude of the authorities or the concerned departments. It means that whether concerned departments, are they paying any attention towards it or not. So this you will explain completely. Okay, so as they are not paying attention, so this is the reason. Means this newspaper has provided you a platform in which you will express your grudges, in which you will express your grief. Means not in particular, it is not related to one person. You know, it is related means for whole society. It means that what you are talking about, it is related to complete society, and this you are going to discuss in this letter to editor. Okay, it means problem in detail. You will present some facts, you will present some statistics, you can also take daily life examples, recent episodes, okay, of happening that has held, that was of course the hottest issue of okay, over the times. Okay, so you will discuss all this. It means that you will intensify the problem here. You will really make the editor understand that yes, this is the actual problem and how people are being affected by it, and of course it is affecting the life of the people, right? So you will write in this manner. Okay, so now after writing here in para 3, you will make a request to publish your views. Okay, so why you will publish your views? You will publish your views because ultimately you have written a letter to pass on your views to editor. But what editor can do? If he will not publish the letter, if he will publish the letter this in the newspaper, then this will completely be read by the concerned authorities also, and they will also try to take an action against it. Okay, because the problems which have not been solved over time, they can try to solve those problems. They can solve those problems as they will come to know, yes, the people are really being affected. Okay, so this is how this letter to editor is written. So how you will make a request? So I hope that I request you to give a room to my views in your esteemed newspaper, so that the concerned authorities can wake up from their deep slumber or it can meet the eyes. Meet the eyes. Meet the eyes means? Meet the eyes of the concerned authority. So what is the meaning of meet the eyes? Meet the eyes means that they can understand the situation. They can understand. They can come to know about the reality of the situation. Yes, that yes, this is the problem and this is why it is happening. Okay. Clear now? And ultimately, you will write down yours truly. Yours truly and then your name. You will write down. Okay. So this is how the letter to editor is written. Now I'm going to give you a question. Okay. You have to write down in your notebooks. Write down. You are Ritik or Ritika of New Delhi. Okay. So boys will write down Ritik and girls will write down Ritika. Okay. And with increase in choices of processed food and inactive lifestyle, with an increased use of processed food and inactive lifestyle, you can note down side by side, with an increased use of processed food and inactive lifestyle, the problem of obesity is rising. The problem of obesity is rising. Note it down side by side. The problem of obesity is rising. Write a letter. Write a letter to the editor of an English daily to show your concern about the issue and suggest some measures to solve this problem. Means you will suggest, naturally you will suggest some measures also. When you are giving a problem, you will definitely give solutions to it. Okay, according to your opinion, right? So this letter you have to write down in your fair notebooks. And while checking, this writing skill must be done, as letter writing is, you can say, is letter writing is one of the main tasks. Okay, in your writing part. Okay, so that's all for today. If you have any doubts, now you can ask me.